Muka surat 1, 2, 3, kereaktifan logam. Bab yang baru, kereaktifan logam. Metal, reactivity. What is reactive? The chapter title, right? Reactive. Apa maksud reactive? Okay, now you take a metal. Okay, what is the example of metal that all of you all know? Contoh logam. Aluminium. All of you know, right? Aluminium. Aluminium is a metal one. Aluminium foil, the aluminium. So that aluminium, you put it in the acid. That aluminium, you put in the acid, it will react. How it will react? You know, Panadol you put in the water? What will happen to Panadol you put in the water? Like zzz, like that, the sound will come and then it gets small and small and small and small. That is something we call reaction, reactive. So logam adalah reactive, but there are many types of metal. Ada banyak logam. Look at the page 1, 2, 3. Look at the top. Kalium. In English, potassium, natrium, calcium, magnesium, aluminium. Yang ni semua adalah logam. All these are metal. Semua ni adalah logam. And this one can react. If you see the arrow from down to up, yang mana paling reactive? Which is very reactive?
Kalium.
Potassium. Because the arrow is going up. So yang mana paling reactive? Kalium. Potassium. Very reactive. Less reactive? Emas. Kurang reactive? Emas. So you have to understand this. Ada banyak logam. So some of them will ask teacher how to remember all this. I will tell you which metal is important. You remember that metal enough. Tak perlu semua. Clear? Now, look at the page 1, 2, 4. Kepelbagaian mineral. There are many types of mineral. Mineral get from where? Dari mana? Kerak bumi. Earth crust. Like you dig the soil. From there you can get the mineral. So mineral dapat dari mana? Kerak bumi. Earth crust. What are the example of mineral? Look at page 125. A. Element. Unsur. Element. Example gold. Emas. Berlian. Diamond. Perak. Silver. These are all elements. All these you get from where? Kerak bumi. Earth crust. You get from the earth. Second one, sebatian. Compound. Compound like bauxite. Look at the picture. Bauxite, hematite, galena, cassiterite. All these also you get from the earth. If you see A, A adalah unsur. B adalah sebatian. Elements compound. Compound because it's like mix up. Unsur is only one. That is the difference. So, yang ni semua adalah apa? Contoh-contoh mineral. Examples of mineral. Dapat dari mana? Kerak bumi. Earth crust. Look at the last table. First one, hematite. Nama scientific. The scientific name, ferrum oxida. This ferrum oxida, bila kamu pisahkan, when you separate that, what will you get? Ferrum oxygen. You see that. So, when it combine, ferrum oxygen combine, ferrum oxida. Next one, bauxite. You learn this word bauxite in geography. Bauxite. You know, bijet timah, emas, bauxite like that. Okay, so bauxite, aluminium oxida, the scientific name, aluminium oxide. When you separate, what will you get?
Aluminium
oxygen. Next one, galena, plumbum. So plumbum sulfida. When you separate plumbum, sulfida comes from sulfur. So plumbum, sulfur. Last one, calcium. Calcium, carbonate. So when you separate calcium, carbonate is what? Carbon, oxygen. Ada tiga. Now teacher says separate. So calcium, carbonate, when you separate calcium. Carbonate actually got two. Carbon. Another one, oxygen. That's how you look at that. So you have to know these are all the elements inside. Unsur yang ada di dalam. Look at page 127. Experiment. This is an important experiment. Experiment yang penting. Gambar pertama. If PDT question come out, this will be the question. The before notes all is just basic. Yang penting adalah eksperimen. Okay, lihat gambar. Apa ada dalam tabung D-Day? What is in the boiling tube? Calcium carbonate, acid hydrochloric. I didn't write the equation on the whiteboard. Calcium carbonate plus acid hydrochloric. Acid, you all know. So they mix up. When they mix, what you will get? Calcium chloride plus carbon dioxide plus I. That will be your result. Why? You have to remember the equation. Some of them you'll go and memorize. If you understand, no need to memorize. Look properly. Calcium carbonate plus acid hydrochloric. Hydrochloric. So when hydrochloric mix, calcium will mix with the chlorine. So will be calcium chloride. After reaction will have the da sound. Calcium chloride plus. So you cut the word calcium, you cut the word chlorine. So balance is what? Carbonate. So that carbonate will become carbon dioxide. Balance got another one more. Hydro. That hydro is water. That is your equation. I repeat back. Calcium carbonate plus acid hydrochloric. They mixed it. They will give that in exam. Calcium carbonate, acid hydrochloric, they mix. What will you get? Calcium chloride will become calcium chloride. Calcium chloride. Plus the carbonate will become carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. Balance in front got what? Hydro. That hydro is water. So plus I. Itu adalah persamaan untuk eksperimen ini. Look at the beside diagram. Cikgu tak suruh kamu lukis, tapi yang tu pun penting. Look at the second diagram. The second diagram, only calcium carbonate. No acid hydrochloric. What they do with the calcium carbonate?
Panaskan.
They heat up. Just now, first one, they didn't heat up. The second one, they heat up. So when heat up, you already learn in Form 1 to burn. What you need? What gas you need to burn?
Oxygen.
Apa gas yang penting untuk pembakaran? Combustion. What gas? Oxygen. So now the calcium carbonate panas kan? What is the equation? Calcium carbonate, arrow. So mix with oxygen already, the second one. So already mix with oxygen. Calcium plus oxygen become what? Oxida. I told the word da. In English, calcium oxide. Balance carbonate, right? So gas will be carbon dioxide. So this is the equation. What is in the other tube there? Air kapur. If you see, there's a tube going there, right? Sebelah sana ada air kapur. Air kapur untuk apa? Menguji gas to test carbon dioxide. That is a function. In exam, they cannot remember. This one will be like one set of question. Satu set. They gave me the experiment picture. Then they ask persamaan. So you have to write the persamaan. Then they can ask you air kapur untuk apa? Tujuan air kapur. For what is air kapur? Untuk menguji gas carbon dioxide. To test carbon dioxide gas. Okay, done. The next question they can ask you. Apakah pemerhatian? What is the observation? What will you see? You know already the equation, right? What gas is released there? Carbon dioxide. So, you know carbon dioxide release. So, when carbon dioxide release, can you see carbon dioxide? You cannot see the gas. But the gas go to air kapur. What will happen to air kapur? Keruh. K-E-R-U-H. Keruh. In English, lime water turns cloudy. These are all basic information. Apakah pemerhatian? What you see, air kapur menjadi keruh. Maybe they can ask you inference. What is inference? Reason. Why? Kerana gas carbon dioxide dibebaskan. What is the reason? Carbon dioxide gas is released. I'm giving you all the type of question. If everything doesn't come, at least one or two question will come. Inference, reason. Kenapa air kapur menjadi keruh? Kerana gas carbon dioxide dibebaskan. Carbon dioxide gas is released. Look at the next page 129. Siri kereaktifan logam. The siri. Siri means what? Susunan. The arrangement. Look at the green box first. Dalam tindak balas yang cergas. What is cergas? Vigorous reaction. What is vigorous? Like very high reaction. Like I told teacher told you when you put panadol in the water. Like bubbles, all that is vigorous. Vigorous means like very fast. That is cergas. In Malay, tinda balas yang cergas. Antara logam yang lebih reaktif. Seperti magnesium. Remember, magnesium is a metal. And magnesium sangat reaktif. It's very, very, very reaktif. Tadi kita lihat yang mana paling reaktif? Kalium. Potassium. Remember the kalium. But if you see the arrangement there, you can see Mg. What is Mg? Magnesium. That is magnesium. So magnesium is very reactive. Magnesium oxygen, like you burn, it will react very fast. That's why they tell tinda balas reaction. Tinda balas cergas. Vigorous reaction. And how you know the one is vigorous reaction? What they gave there? Nyalaan yang terang. Because they mix in oxygen. Magnesium, oxygen. Some of them will ask teacher, how magnesium oxygen? Oxygen is here. How magnesium? Maksudnya dipanaskan. Magnesium and oxygen dipanaskan. They heat up. Because when you panaskan, only oxygen there, what? So magnesium, oxygen dipanaskan. Bila dipanaskan, apa yang kamu perhatikan? What you observe? Nyalaan terang. Bright flame. Nyalaan terang. Bright flame. So you, if you see bright flame, what must you remember? Very reactive. Second one. Tinda balas yang kurang cergas. What is kurang cergas? Less vigorous. Less vigorous means not very reactive lah. Example, besi dengan oksigen hanya baraan. What is baraan? Glowing. Just like the red, bara only. Atau perubahan warna yang berlaku secara perlahan-lahan. The color changes will be slow. Like slowly. Like fire all won't come. Just like reddish like that. But if you see magnesium, fire. Nyalaan yang terang. Bright flame. But if you see besi, besi in English is what? Iron. The one is less vigorous. Kurang cergas. So logam mana paling reaktif? Magnesium. Logam mana kurang reaktif? Besi. Look at the arrow. The important metal that you should know is magnesium. Aluminium, Al. Magnesium, Mg. Aluminium, Al. Zinc, Zn. Ferrum, Fe. Cuprum, Cu. I give you 5. So this 5, magnesium, aluminium, zinc, ferrum. In English, ferrum is what? Iron. And then cuprum. So total 5. This 5 is the important 5 metals. How to remember? Muz. Fk. Muz. M-A-Z. Magnesium, aluminium, zinc, Muz. F-K, ferrum, cuprum. Cuprum in Malay lah, K. So, Muz, F-K. Yang mana paling reaktif? Magnesium. Yang mana kurang reaktif? Cuprum. In this 5. So usually this 5 metal is the important metal they will ask in exam. Next page. Page 130. Look at the diagram. Very important experiment. Just now diagram and this diagram. Ada dua experiment penting. Look at this experiment. Look at the title up there. Logam terhadap oksigen. Teacher tell you how logam and oxygen react. Panaskan. Logam, oxygen, panaskan. What they gave in the diagram? Serpo logam, metal powder. But they never tell what metal. So it can be magnesium, it can be aluminium, it can be zinc, ferrum, cuprum, copper. So this one is serpo logam. The others are got like purple color, right? Hapalor kalium manganate. Potassium manganate crystal. It's a purple. For what is that? It will come in your exam. Untuk apa hapalor kalium manganate? Membekalkan oksigen. Supply oksigen. Because this one is experiment. What experiment? Metal oxygen. So how you will get oxygen? This hapalor will give oxygen. Kalium manganate. Listen to my pronunciation. Kalium manganate. Potassium manganate. For what is that? Fungsi. They will ask fungsi. Function. What? Supply oxygen. Memberi oxygen. Give oxygen. Supply oxygen. Can. Another one more. Final. Wool culture. That's a glass wool. For what is that glass wool? In the middle, for what is a glass wool? Untuk memisahkan serbo logam dan hablur kalium manganate. To separate. For what is wool kaca? Untuk memisahkan serbo logam dan hablur kalium manganate. To separate metal powder and the potassium manganate crystal. Or sometimes they will say, so that these two doesn't mix. Memisahkan also can, but to prevent this from mixing. Sometimes the reaction happens, this one can mix. So wool culture is for what? To prevent it from mixing. Also can. Mengelakkannya daripada bercampur. Mengelakkan serbo logam dan hablur kalium manganate daripada bercampur. So that it doesn't mix. Now, that serbo logam, teacher put magnesium. Apa serbo logam?
Magnesium. Magnesium.
Now teacher put the metal powder is magnesium. Dipanaskan. Panaskan is what? Plus oxygen. What will be your equation? Magnesium plus oxygen. Because panaskan why? So panaskan you need oxygen. Magnesium plus oxygen. What do you get? Magnesium?
Oxida.
I told after the reaction, oxida. In English, magnesium oxide. Look at the page 131, the A, B, C, D, E. Magnesium plus oxygen, magnesium oxide. Oxida. Magnesium oxida. If you put aluminium?
Aluminium
oxida. If you put zinc and oxygen? Zinc oxida. Zinc oxide. If you put ferrum oxygen? Ferrum oxida. If you put plumbum oxygen, plumbum oxida, lead oxide. So this is the important experiment. Today we will stop until here, half of the chapter.